Good morning, children. Welcome to our grammar class. So last class we started our new chapter, that is preposition, and we studied at, isn't it? We studied one preposition, that is at. So where we have to use at? Yeah, at point outs, place, yes, address, activity, or time, yes. So, it points out a specific time, place or address or an activity. So, today we are going to study other three prepositions. That is, first one is what? Near. So, near, it points out something or someone that is closed by. Okay. For example, there is a beach near my home. So, there is a beach near my home. Home. So, it points out something closed by. Understood? That is close to. The school is near Tagore Hall. So, our school is where? It is near to Tagore Hall. She stood near me. So, near me means it is close to. Understood? So, near point out something or someone that is closed by. Understood? Adutha. Yes. There is a beach near my home. So here, near is a preposition. Our school is near Tagore Hall. Near Tagore Hall. She stood near me. Understood? So near point out something or someone that is closed by. Understood? So these all are what? Preposition. The first one what we studied? At. Then near. Understood? Then the next one, that is the third one, that is around. Third one is so around means surrounding or circling on every side. So around means surrounding or circling every side. That means surrounding all the sides of something or someone. Understood? That is surrounding all sides of something or someone. For example, there is a fence around the garden. There is a fence around the garden. So, the fence is around the garden. So, the fence is surrounding all sides of the garden. Islands have water around them. So, islands have water around them. You know what is an island, isn't it? It is surrounded by water. The islands are surrounded by water. So, islands have water around them. Children sat around the teacher. So, children sat around the teacher. So, where are these children sitting? It is around the teacher. Understood? So, around means surrounding or circling on every side. It is surrounded by all sides. Understood? Next, around also means circling something or someone. Around also means circling someone or something. For example, earth moves around the sun. Earth moves around the sun. You have studied in the science, isn't it? Earth moves around the sun. So, it is circling around something or someone. Understood? Next example, they dance around the campfire. So, where were they dancing? They were dancing around the campfire. Understood? So, around means surrounding or circling on every side. Understood? That is surrounding all the sides or it is circling all the sides. Understood? Circling around something or someone. There is a fence around the garden. So, this fence is surrounded by, the garden is surrounded by the fence. Islands have water around them. Islands have water around them. The children sat around the teacher. The children sat around the teacher. Then the earth moves around them. Around the sun. The earth moves around the sun. So earth is circling the sun. Understood? So we studied the preposition at, then. And what we studied? Near, then preposition around. Understood? Around means what? Around means surrounding or circling something or someone. Understood? Okay. Next, what we have to study? We have to study another preposition, that is above or over. Above or over. What do you mean by that? The place that is higher that of someone or something. So, over and above means a place that is higher than someone or something. It is higher than someone or something. The plane is flying above the clouds. So, where the plane is flying? Plane is flying above the clouds. The apple is over the box. So, apple is over the box. The apartment is located above the garage. So, where is the apartment located? It is above the garage. So, above and over means the same. That is, at a place that is higher than someone or something. So, over and above means a place that is higher than someone or something. Understood? Mugali, over. The plane is flying above the clouds. The apple is over the box. So, where is the apple? It is over the box. The apartment is located above the garage. So, where is the apartment? It is above the garage. So, above means at a place that is higher than something or someone. Understood? Next one is beside, at the side of, or next to. So the next preposition is beside, or at the side of, or next to. So these three are having the same meaning. Okay. These three refers to the position at the side of something or someone. Understood? Beside means next to. These three have the same meaning. Understood? It shows the position at the side. Understood? It shows the position of the side. Side of something or someone. For example, the Meena is standing beside her brother. So, where is Meena standing? She is standing beside her brother. Meena is standing next to her brother. It also means the same meaning. Understood? Meena is standing at the side of her brother. Understood? So, these all means what? It tells the position of at the side. It tells the position at the side of something or someone. Understood? So, the Meena is standing beside her brother. Means, side of her brother. The Meena is standing next to her brother. Understood? Next one, the Meena is standing at the side of her brother. Understood? Means next to her brother. Position at the side. Understood? So, we have studied, how many prepositions we have studied? We have studied preposition at, then. Near, then. Around, then. Over and above, then. The fifth one is beside, at the side of, or next to. Understood? So I hope you have understood all these prepositions. What means these prepositions means what? Understood? Next we'll move on to our exercise. Okay. Now take out your textbook. Take chapter 10. Take chapter 10. Exercise number 1. I have told you to do exercise number 1 in the last class. Isn't it? So, we'll just discuss the answers and we'll move on to the next exercise. Okay? First one, match the position of the owl in the picture which is with the correct preposition. Okay? First one is what? Where is the owl sitting? Yes, it is. It is on the box. It is on the box. Next one, where is the owl standing? It is between. boxes, isn't it? It's between the boxes. Next, C. So where is the owl? Where is the owl? It is behind the box. It is behind the box. Next one. D. Where is the owl? Yeah, it is. It is below the box. It is below the box. Next. Where is the owl? He is moving. Yeah, it is moving around the box. It is moving around the box. Next one. Where is the owl? It is standing in front of the box. It is standing in front of the box. So now I hope you understood the prepositions, isn't it? So the next exercise number 2 and exercise number 3. 3 is very easy. You have to draw that. Okay. So exercise 2, 3 and 4 that you have to complete for the next class. Okay. So I will give you the answers through WhatsApp. Last 2 chapters also I have to give. So that also I will give you in the WhatsApp. Okay. Because it is difficult for me to correct there. We don't have enough space to correct there. That's why I am giving the answers through WhatsApp. Okay. So do this exercise. Complete it by next week. Okay. Thank you and have a great day.